Hi guys, welcome back again to a great new exciting video from Tech Guy. Guys, I made a video comparing Intel and AMD processors head to head. Now guys, in this video, I will be showing you some of the AMD portfolio and their processors and talk about how they have grown over time. So let's get started. Starting with AMD processors. There are three main types of AMD processors out today. First one is the most popular AMD Ryzen, which directly compares to its Intel counterparts. The second one is AMD Threadripper, which is made for workstations. The fourth one is AMD EPYC, which features a whopping 128 cores. Now let's talk about AMD Ryzen series processors. These are the most popular processors out from AMD. They are specifically built for gaming and have high performance due to their more number of cores, and they compare against Intel counterparts like the Core i3, i5, i7 and i9. Now let's talk about AMD Ryzen portfolio. First one is Ryzen 3. Ryzen 3 is designed for budget-friendly consumers who don't want to use their PCs for intensive applications. That is, those who want to just browse the web, watch videos, do some Excel work, etc. It is not meant for gamers. Then the next, Ryzen 5. Ryzen 5 is a family of mid-range processors that lies between Ryzen 3 and Ryzen 7. And it is a mid-range processor designed by AMD for desktops and laptops. It is quite good and it can provide gaming performance also in desktop mode. Now let's talk about Ryzen 7. Ryzen 7 is a very high efficiency processor manufactured by AMD for desktop computers, laptop and mobile devices. Ryzen 7 is made specifically for gaming enthusiasts and digital artists such as filmmakers and animators. It provides very high performance in all the aspects and one can easily use them for gaming. Now let's talk about Ryzen 9. They are enthusiast grade processors. They are specifically designed for extreme hardcore gamers and video editors. They have very high number of cores, which increase performance significantly. And they are a great choice for even workstations, power users, and content creators. So guys, that was all about the Ryzen portfolio. Now let's talk about each specific Ryzen series separately. So starting off with Ryzen 3. Now first we will talk about mobile processors, that is the processors which are used in laptops, and then we will talk about desktop processors, the processors that are used in computer and PCs. First of all, in mobile processor, the first one is Ryzen 3250U. It is an old processor now, but it is still used in laptops. Now let's talk about Ryzen 4300U. It is a very nice processor. Ryzen 3 is made to compete with i3, but Ryzen 3 features 4 cores now instead of 2 cores from Intel Core i3. Ryzen 4300U is a very capable processor and it is quite
powerful
in comparison to Intel Core i3. Now next is Ryzen 5300U. It is the latest generation of Ryzen 3 processor. It is quite good and it has a bit more improvement as compared to Ryzen 4300U. Then now we will talk about desktop processors, starting off with Ryzen 3100. It is the baseline processor of desktop portfolio from Ryzen 3. It is a quite good processor for everyday use.
Next,
talking about Ryzen 3200G. The G here is specified because all of the processors do not have any graphics in them in desktop portfolio, but specifically the G series have integrated graphics in them. This is a very popular processor from Ryzen 3 portfolio. It is also quite high performing in terms of everyday task and office related works. Next up is Ryzen 3300X. It is a very powerful processor. X here stands for extreme. It is a processor specifically made for very budget minded gamers, and it is specifically designed for them. Next up is Ryzen 5300G. It is the latest Ryzen desktop processor which features graphics integrated in it. Then we will talk about Ryzen 5 now. So let's get started. First of all, mobile processors. Then we will talk about desktop processors. First is Ryzen 3500U. It is the base processor and it is not used nowadays. Then Ryzen 3550H. It is an old-fashioned processor and it was used in laptops which require gaming and more power as compared to thin and light laptops. Next is Ryzen 4500U. It is a huge leap as compared to early generation processor. It features 6 cores and it was made to overcast the i5 processor, but surprisingly it even outperformed core i7 processor also. Next is Ryzen 4600H. This processor is meant for gaming laptops and it also features 6 cores, but it has more multi-threaded performance. Next is Ryzen 5500. This is the latest generation of Ryzen 5 thin and light laptop processor. It is also very capable processor and it is significantly better than Ryzen 4500U. Then next is Ryzen 5600H. This Ryzen processor is meant for gaming laptops. It also showed significantly higher performance than Ryzen 4600H. Now moving on to desktop processor. First off with Ryzen 3400G. This processor is known because it has integrated graphics and it is immensely popular. Next is Ryzen 3500. It is also a very popular CPU. And next off is Ryzen 3600. It is one of the most popular selling Ryzen desktop processor because it is quite in budget and it provides handsome amount of power to gamers and even video editors also. Next is Ryzen 3600X. It is high performing version of Ryzen 3600. Next is Ryzen 5600G, which is not released yet but has been announced. It is the latest desktop processor from Ryzen 5 and it also features integrated graphics. Next up is Ryzen 5600X. It is the latest gaming processor from Ryzen. I love this processor and probably it's the best value for money. It provides excellent power and even the Ryzen 7 and Ryzen 9 are not that significantly better in gaming performance than Ryzen 5600X.
So guys, this was all about Ryzen 3 and Ryzen 5.
Hope you guys like this video. In the next video, I will be continuing with Ryzen 7 and Ryzen 9. Till then, bye-bye.